you for supporting them. I know it's really, whenever you play that song, everyone recognizes it. Everyone gets that. And actually, that song, along with Fear of the Champions, those were designed to be played together, which is why most of the time at sporting events, those two songs played back to back. It was written that way. And also, another one, Bites the Dust. Michael Jackson was in the audience for one of Queen's concerts in LA, and he said to the band afterwards, "Hey, I really think you should release that as a single." So the next year they did. Because of Michael Jackson. So that's a pretty cool fun fact. Alright, Sixth Graders. And so thank you for listening to this episode.
Thank you.
next tune we're going to do is called Livin' on a Prayer. I think you probably know that one. Who is it by? Bon Jovi, absolutely. This is by far the band's most recognized song ever recorded. It has been played forever and ever and ever and ever. Downloaded streams, re-recorded, remixed. It is one of the more popular songs that you will come across. So we're going to play a version of it. By Paul Murtha. And I really love this tune, and I think the kids really like it too. It's so fun to be able to teach the rock music that people really grew up with and that my parents listen to. They love this stuff. And it's really fun to just kind of go back and listen to it again and hear a band as young as they are play it well. It's really fun. Here we go.
Keyboard player's last name was Payne, and he often called home saying,
struggling as a musician in Los Angeles. I'm not making it. I really think I need to quit. I'm not going anywhere. And his father would always just tell him, don't stop believing. And he used those lyrics and he put them in the song, and Don't Stop Believing became the most number one digitally downloaded song of the 20th century, which is pretty impressive. So here we go, Don't Stop Believing. Alright, so this is our final ensemble tonight, our high school band. There are 38 of them currently on stage, which I'm super happy with that number. They are such a joy to work with every single day. I have them third hour, and our band room is kind of small for them, but that's both the problem and a little bit, but it's a good problem. I'm really happy with these kids behind me. They've worked so hard perfecting their sound and just listening to them every single day. It really makes my day, and it makes me, I love my job because of these guys behind me. And they are so awesome to work with. First song we're going to be doing is Africa by Toto. This song, the chorus was actually recorded in only 10 minutes. Or sorry, it was composed in only 10 minutes, the lyrics of the chorus. But the rest of the song was worked on for 6 months before it was presented to the band. So even though they got the majority of the song done in 10 minutes, the rest of it took 6 months. And when they released it, it was just a huge, huge song that came out. It really does honor the continent of Africa and the people living on it. And I remember I was watching a video of the band, one of the band members, and he was talking about the first time they actually got to perform Africa in Africa. And it was just this awesome moment. You know, like when you get goosebumps? That's what that moment was for them. So this is Africa by Toto.
Thank you.
Now, my third and probably my favorite song on the program, the high school band, would be Bohemian Rhapsody. You clap for that. I know you do. Okay, now one band is famous for Bohemian Rhapsody. Queen. We did two Queen songs earlier, World Rock You, and another one by the Dust. So here's a third Queen song, Bohemian Rhapsody. It actually wasn't composed by all the band members, though, just Freddie Mercury. The entire thing was all Freddie Mercury composing, and he actually started drafting ideas for Bohemian Rhapsody back in the 60s. He would write little melodic motifs on napkins or post-it notes, and he would just kind of build this whole piano melodic progression over time. And eventually, in the early 80s, he actually started sitting down and actually writing it. The song was incredibly complex to record. Well, first of all, it's not a typical pop song. Instead of a chorus, it has six different sections. It's like the opera section, the rock section, the ballad, introduction, the closing, the coda, et cetera, et cetera. And when they recorded it in three big chunks, and they had to use multiple recording techniques because at the time, they were only able to do 24 layers of dubbing, which is the recording technique, because the song has a lot of layers. You know, when Freddie Mercury says, because they just kept adding in Galileos. Thank you, that's why I'm not a choir director. The song actually took about 180 dubs overall. When the limit was 24 at the time, so recording it was a very lengthy process. It took 3 weeks and many takes. But what was left was a final product that was just fantastic and it stood the test of time. It has 2 billion streams on Spotify. It is a big deal. Here we go. You guys are fantastic. Thank you for encouraging your students to pursue this music. It's really good for them in a lot of ways, and it shows, I think. So thank you again. I hope you have a great night, fantastic end of the year as we wrap it up next week, and have a safe trip home.